But I think people forget who you are and where you came from. When this thing happened with George Floyd and that man was murdered, he was lynched in front of the whole world. You came forward and you said, you know what? This reminds me of my own experiences. Before we get to all the great things that you're doing, can you just open the door, the curtain a little bit? You are one of the most successful human beings on earth. You're still a black man. What did the George Floyd thing bring up for you?
You know, Van, a whole lifetime of emotions, a lifetime of disappointment in systems that have failed African Americans and continue to fail African Americans. And, you know, the world was quiet, because of COVID. It shut down sports. It shut down a lot of distractions. And so those 8 minutes and 46 seconds grabbed the world's attention in a way that I don't think any other event has in a while. And it spoke to us in a way that really questioned our humanity. And it made us realize and think about, you know, who we want to be, who we want to be as humans, who we want to be as a country, who we want to be as citizens in this country, and how we're going to treat each other. And that realization hit so many people so hard. And what was beautiful about it was the young people did not hesitate.
That's right.
You know, I think a year or two younger than you, but, you know, folks our age, Van, yeah. We hesitate, we talk, we try to think about, we evaluate. These young people went out into the streets, and it was the broadest coalition. I think they're now saying it was probably the largest movement in the history of the planet at this point that is still ongoing. And they said, this is not right. This is not fair.
Yep.
This is unjust, and we need to do something about it. And it harkens back to a time I think about when I was a young boy growing up in Denver, Colorado, when me and a couple of my friends would ride our bicycles at the city park, which I lived across the street from. And why did the police officers stop these two or three brown kids and check the serial numbers on our bicycles?
Wow.
So here I am at age 6 and 7 and 8, memorizing my serial number of my bicycle. And then years later, and I told folks about this, where I had an uncle, he graduated, just got his master's degree, just got recently married, got a job with the state to inspect some of the state facilities. So he had a state car and a state credit card, and he was in one of the towns in Colorado, and he was filling up the car, and the gas station attendant said, why is an African-American got a state credit card? It must be stolen. This car must be stolen. And he shot him and he killed him. And I was 10 years old at that time. And so when I see these sort of things with George Floyd and Ahmaud Arbery and Breonna Taylor, it brings up a lifetime of pain that we have to change. And I think we've done a good job with a lot of our kids to say, this is not right. And so they moved. And now we have to get the adults, the corporate owners, the administration, the members of Congress to say, this is not right. And we have to make real substantive changes and eradicate racism in this country. It is killing this country. It's killing the citizens of this country, and it's killing who we are in the context of the world.
Yeah.
And that's got to change.